serious, what was the closest you've ever been to killing someone? When I was 15, I carried my 2-year-old cousin down a flight of stairs. When I tripped and we fell down 3 steps, she fell on the back of her head and I on top of her. It took a split second before she started crying and I thought she was dead. Thankfully, she was fine. But I'm so glad she didn't fall harder or over the handrail, or else she would have fallen at least 3 meters and would probably be dead. Edit. Kinda reassuring that stuff like this seems to happen a lot and not just to clumsy 15-year-old me. This unattended kid ran into the street as I turned into it. Didn't even see him at all because of how tiny he was. Just heard something hit my side view mirror and that's when I saw him rubbing his head. Nurse here. Unit was very busy and I mentioned to her patient we needed to start her on antibiotics. Patient consented. I hung penicillin. Only to find out our computer said she's anaphylactic allergic to penicillin. Incredibly. She must have outgrown her childhood allergy. Beat myself up for a long time for that near miss. Won't make that mistake again. Driving tired once. Had a micro sleep and woke up driving down the wrong side of the road. Fortunately it was late at night. No traffic around. But could easily have killed myself and my passenger. Never driven tired since. Drunk student fell into the road in front of me. I swerved and wrote off 2 cars and injured my passenger. I was fine. He didn't even hang around to thank me. Little wanker. Edit. The amount of edgy goons who try and make compelling arguments that I should have killed him is disgusting. I'm very happy with how things turned out and as stated many times it was literally the most legal and safe thing I could have done. As was decided in court. Some of you are literally brainwashed to think that your personal property is worth more than a young human life and that's honestly disturbing as duck. I'm glad I grew up where I did and was taught the morals I was because the world scares the duck out of me if you think I should have killed some poor drunk kid in order to save some low-level criminal's new car. When my younger sister was in middle school, she took a very sudden and unexplained dip in personality. She went from being a bouncy, sunny kid who loved going outside and seeing her friends to kind of reserved and struggling to keep her grades up. Her friends stopped coming around. Crazy rumors about her started, and she was just overall really depressed and nervous. Our parents were very into the just suck it up mentality so they told her to just push through and be better. I tried to get her to tell me what had happened and she told me the same thing she told our parents. The kids at school were bullying her and her friends were being mean. I didn't buy it, but there was nothing I could do. One day at the dinner table, we were all talking about town gossip as was family custom. And my mom brought up how a teacher at my sister's school was looking for a hand in getting rid of some old furniture from his late father's house and that my mother had volunteered the family to help out that coming weekend. My sister immediately broke down into having sobs, howling at the top of her lungs as though someone had died. And you can probably guess where it went from there. She confessed that her teacher's son, who was a sophomore when my sister was in 7th grade, had assaulted her and when she tried to tell the teacher about it, he shut her down and called her a liar and had said he would fail her if she tried to tell anyone about it. I had to spend the following day in class with this asshole while my parents sorted out how to handle the situation and it took everything I had not to lose my it on this kid. I am not a violent person but I had to sit there with him a foot away and all I could think about was smashing his face into the tile until the light left his eyes. That was over 10 years ago and he's in jail now but I still think I'd have to contain myself if I was in the same room as him again. Right after suffering a miscarriage, my sister told me that I don't know what being a family is like since it was just me and my husband. And that kids make a family. I had to be dragged away by my husband. Was ready to go to prison over that itch. When I found out my wife had been raped by her father. When I was like 14 or so I was on a swing at a park. I was going about as high and fast as that swing could possibly go. A kid who couldn't be older than 2 wandered directly in front of me as I was coming down. I slammed my feet on the ground and stopped myself about an inch away from her. My hands started to bleed from the chain but at least I didn't drop kick a 2-year-old all the way across the park. The mother saw the thing happen but she was too far away from us to do anything in the moment but she ran over crying and thanking me for stopping. My mum was dying in hospice. It was undignified and she was in a lot of pain. But she was still lucid. I asked her if she wanted me to help her speed things up. For context, she was a nurse before she got sick and I knew what I could do to make things happen. She told me she wished I could, but didn't want me to get in trouble or go to jail. We laughed about it a little bit. I maintained I would have a ball in jail. She died later that week. I spent most of it by her side. I am 100% pro-assisted euthanasia. Watching her go was torturous. Had a patient who was essentially a vegetable. I had to wrestle with him and keep him pinned to the bed. Most of his muscles had contractions, but he was still shaking and stuff due to the pain we were probably inflicting on him, while the nurse pumped fluids out of his lung through a hole in his neck. This guy's entire existence was just lying in bed being in pain, semi-choking on the fluids his body was producing inside his lungs, only to be pinned down, have us remove the worst parts of it, and the cycle to begin anew every hour or so. It was heartbreaking. This was not healthcare, this was torture. It would have been more humane to let him die. I felt ashamed and still do because I could not bring myself to kill the man. My boss asked me why I wasn't doing any work after working a 70-hour work week and taking one lunch break for the week. I was so mad and work a job where we carry knives on our person, I had to throw it across the room and I just picked up my bag and walked out. This was all before my actual start time, after I had been working almost half an hour and still wasn't supposed to start for another half hour. I had started a grease fire in a pot on the stove while cooking for a date. Panic set in as it was kind of big fire. Only thing I could think of was baking soda would be the only thing to put it out, because that's what they taught us in school, right? Ransacked my cupboards. Couldn't find it. Next best thing that came to mind? Dirt from outside. Ran outside to get some dirt. Told her not to pour water on it, that I'll be right back. As I'm out there, I hear her scream and a flash of orange. My heart sank and I froze for a second. Did I just kill my date? Back inside. She's fine. Fire is smaller but still going. My walls and ceiling are scorched. I ask her what happened. She replied. She poured milk on the fire because milk is thicker than water. Comma okay. Anyway. No one was harmed in all this, thankfully. Except my bank account, when my security deposit didn't cover the damages done when I moved out later. Oh well. I do have more fire stories from that apartment. Pretty sure my landlord thought I was an arsonist. Or a dumb kid on his first time living alone. Pretending to be an adult. Edit to add, thank you for the all the put the lid on next time recommendations. I now know that's an option. Like I said, I was panicking and wasn't thinking straight. I do now have multiple fire extinguishers throughout my current place. They were all were gifted to me by family after I told them this story. Those were fun birthday Christmas gifts that year. Also, there was no second date and we did not smash, lol. Mom was in an abusive relationship for about 8 years. About 6 years into it, me and my ex stopped by to pick mom up as she said the guy was drunk and she wanted to leave. We arrive and as I approach the front steps, I look up into the glass door and see a pair of hands shove my mother out of view. She went ducking flying. I raged out. Grabbed an axe that was nearby. Dude would chop trees on property and sell bundled firewood. As the guy stepped out front and downstairs, I chased him around the perimeter of the property whilst almost blacked out in anger. A buddy of his who was staying there temporarily was on the side of the house smoking a cigarette and tackled me. Luckily, the axe didn't penetrate my chest, seeing as I landed face down with the axe pinned against me. Could have been all types of messy in two ways. Fast forward about 2 years and abusive guy gets into car wreck and passes away about 2 months after I got into car wreck on same street in a similar truck and walked away with cuts and bruises. Grabbed a screwdriver in a desperate attempt to dislodge my ex-husband from pinning strangling me. Swung up and only put a hole in his shirt. Really wish I hadn't missed. When I was 13 years old, I was living in a group home. The boys in the group home were never allowed to go upstairs where the girls' dorms were. I was the only girl who left each day for public school. Everyone else went to school in the basement. Every day, as I would be the only one upstairs getting ready. This one guy snuck up the stairs and forced himself upon me. I told one of the house parents and she laughed at me. After a month of this, I snapped. I stood on top of my bed listening as his footsteps got closer. As soon as he walked into my room, I lunged at him. I wrapped my hands around his throat. As soon as he hit the ground, everyone in the group home came running to see what that sound was. It took several people to pry my hands off that guy's throat. I was arrested and originally charged with attempted murder. Luckily that kid confessed to raping me repeatedly. I was still charged with assault and battery though. I spent 2 months in juvenile detention. I was also given 6 months of house arrest and 6 months of probation. Working at a fast food shop. My friend who was very allergic to peanuts asked for our shop's version of the blizzard. I joked, "You want that with peanut butter cup, right?" Haha, we both chuckled. He said no and asked for cookie dough. For some unspeakable reason. No a single clue why. I made it with cookie dough and peanut butter cups. Handed it to him without a second thought. He brought it back like a minute later and said he thinks he saw peanut butter cup in it. And sure enough. My dumb teenager just put this man's literal death poison in his ice cream. I apologized 100 times. He said it wasn't a big deal. I lived with that anxiety causing thought for a while. Welp, this is the most karma I've ever gotten. What do I do with my hands at this point? My wonderful husband had several brain tumors and died a horrible, painful death. After he died, shortly before our 25th anniversary, 5 different people told me how lucky I was to be a widow and not divorced like them. Grandma got moved to a real shady nursing home. Her concierge doctor, who she paid $3,000 a year to specifically stay a patient, have refused to go anywhere except this one nursing home. It was an old piece of it. First day go to visit her and she is covered in it and piss. Not one person came to check on her or answered her buzzers. They dropped her day 2 and she had to go to hospital. Go to her room to pick up stuff and found a nurse in her chair eating all her food. Day later family was visiting and said her TV was missing and they replaced it with some ghetto smaller one. I rushed right over. And I was like, if they robbed her on top of this, I'm going to kill these goddamned nurses. Turns out the TV was fine and people were just hyped up and over suspicious. The bad nurses did get fired and grandma had an okay time there. I mean, it's a nursing home. They are all pretty much it. I was a little kid and my cousins and siblings, all a few years younger, were in the bathtub and I used the hair dryer to dry my hair. Well, obviously. Then I wanted to make waves for them, so I held the hair dryer very close to the water. My mother and aunt lost it. Will always remember this, how they, for obvious reasons, yelled at me for hours. Never got anything electric close to water again. Edit. Wayo. Thanks for the upvotes. Also, when it is a dumb story and very lucky that nobody happened anything, please tell your children early enough how dangerous electricity and water are. Stepdad spit in my mom's face after not having abused her in over 5 years, so I shoved him. He said he was gonna come back and kill us and ran out the door, so I followed, picked him up from behind, carried him off the porch and slammed him headfirst onto the cement and then just beat the it out of him while neighbors came out. Got arrested. And got my first felony. My older brother, it was after my mother had passed away. I was working 3 jobs so that my older brother and 2 younger brothers could carry on studying and make something of themselves. 4 years and I find out instead of him paying the bills, I was giving him more than enough for all the bills. With the money I was giving him, it was not enough. He was taking out debt on my name. Turned out after 4 years of working 3 jobs non-stop, I was in about 100k debt with no money left in my bank account. The only reason he did not die that day was too many people got in the way. I didn't want to hurt anyone other than that trash of it. 5th grade. We were studying the ancient Greeks. And we had a feast for it. My mom and I prepared baklava. Found out that a girl in my class, let's call her K, was allergic to almonds. She didn't know. Ducking traumatized this 10-year-old boy. Myself. Today. Not gonna do it. Spaghetti for dinner. I love spaghetti. I operate heavy equipment. Dozer excavators. These thing weigh over 30 tons on the light side for perspective. Anyways, we had just started a brine pond project and had just hired some new laborers. They were as green as they come, lol. Anyways, I used my two-way radio to ask them to come over to where I was to tear down a sector barricade so I could proceed. One of the laborers literally ran right up beside my machine without making direct eye contact or radio contact. Industry standard is to do so. I can safe out the machine. I was backing up at the time, so I was watching behind my machine. When I turned around to go forward, the lab were literally 2 inches from my tracks. Needless to say, I've never pressed the engine decal pedal as fast as I did in that situation. If I was new to the machine or inexperienced, the guy would have been an empty toothpaste roll on the ground. Was in my room one day and heard my sister screaming at her BF. Came out and he had laid hands on her. Went to the kitchen. Grabbed the chef's knife. Turned to him and told him to leave or die. He left. Hand on my gun. Ready to draw. Not a cop. Attempted carjacking. Thankfully they noticed and immediately backed up and stopped coming at me. Another second or two and I would have drawn and fired. Had an abusive stepfather when I was a kid. A bit pedo creepy. Would do things like accidentally let his robe gap open with no underwear on. Would start tickle fights as an excuse to get gropey. That sort of thing. That was nothing next to the beatings. Gaslighting. Manipulation and other varieties of psychological and physical torture. I hated him more than I've ever hated anyone in my life, and one night I decided to try to make rat poison tea. Turns out the rat poison we had wouldn't dissolve in the tea. It's for the best. He's still an asshole, but at least I'm not a murderer. Edit, because apparently some folks in the comments thought I was looking for advice on how to kill people or seriously injure them. Stop it, please. I'm not that kid anymore. I don't regret failing to make poison tea. I don't want to hurt anyone, and no one should be committing murder to solve their problems. Have a nice day. Does accidentally count? Because I leaned against an unsteady bit of wall my mum had told me not to. It fell and covered my little brother, 3-ish at the time. Surprisingly, he was mostly okay. A few broken bones and cuts, concussion. But it very much could have killed him. Was out shooting clay pigeons with family. The group next to us decided to go up range without telling us. I yell pull and a clay pigeon gets released. Pigeon flies over to what should be a clear range. Ended up shooting the clay pigeon over a stranger's head. Only injury was a small cut from a piece of rubble from the clay pigeon hitting him. My brother accidentally killed my hamster. I almost choked him to death. A motorcycle was hit by a public utility vehicle and went flying into the side of my car. If I came a split second later, I would have ran the guy over. I've decided if somehow I ever find out the man who molested my 4-year-old sister and gave her ansty, which her finding out about it later in life was a large part of her suicide, that he will die. The chances are slim next to none that it will ever be discovered who that person is, and he could already be dead for all we know. But if I ever found out, I'd send his ducking head to his family for what he did. Didn't see a car coming and almost turned in front of it. My passenger pointed it out to me. Edit. Probs would have hit my passenger. My mate got stabbed 8 times, almost died. We caught the guy but just beat the it out of him. A lot of kicks to the head, but we didn't end up stabbing him like we planned to. I had a girl that bullied me daily in the 9th grade. She told me to kill myself almost every day and that I was worthless. She threatened to beat me up. And even threatened that she would kill me. I went to the counselor and she said it was nothing and I should just ignore it. No one wanted to help me. There was one day she cornered me on the stairs. They were multiple stories and I was on my way to class. She was standing next to the railing. Yelling at me. Telling me how worthless I was and I should just jump off the roof to save everyone the annoyance of knowing me. For a split second I considered pushing her over the railing. We were on the 3rd floor. So I don't know if she would have died or just been severely injured. Regardless, I considered it for 1.5 seconds before I snapped back into reality and just took off down the stairs. I've never been a violent person with violent thoughts. But if she had gotten physical with me, I don't know what I would have done. I was 13 at the time and I'm 25 now. I still remember it sometimes and shudder. I've never had a thought like that since. After months of living with a narcissistic, vile, evil to the core grandmother who also never drew breath, spoke constantly, dribbled it non-stop, and it was a small house so there was no getting away from it. I found out, among many other things, she had been talking really horrible things about me behind my back. Anyway, one day it all just became too much to handle when she would not stop talking and talking about nothing, and I just wanted a moment of peace, so I got up and walked to the kitchen and she started yelling out to be from the lounge, and I stood in the kitchen. Hands on the sink, eyes closed, for probably 5 minutes with her voice echoing in the background. Eventually I picked up a knife and I'll be honest, I was going to kill her, no doubt in my mind. Only thing that stopped me was the idea of wasting my life in prison for someone like her, so I put the knife down, took a few deep breaths and walked back into the lunch room. I know it's not a great look for me, but please, don't envision a sweet old lady sitting in a rocky chair just wanting to talk. No, she is still to this day the worst person I have ever met. She is toxic on a fundamental level. She just sends people to their absolute limits. In the aftermath and in the midst of discovering that my ex-husband was having an affair with someone I considered my best friend. Spoiler, she wasn't a friend at all. She had me babysit her kids while they were screwing. Extra spoiler, she wasn't the first. God, I was dumb. We were in his truck and having a vicious alcohol-fueled argument. He was about to get violent with me, trying to grab me and was going to hit me. Not the first time, I pulled out my .22 handgun, semi-auto, from my coat pocket and held it to his head. I seriously considered just ending him. His attitude changed from aggressive to whoa whoa whoa, decided he wasn't worth it. I had better things to do with my life and people, family, children, who depended on me. He backed off. So I shot the gun into the ground out of my window. That felt good and released the anger into innocent dirt. Got out of the truck and told him to never come back. Dumped his crap in the yard and changed the locks. That was 32 years ago. Best decision ever. Divorced and didn't kill the bastard. Edit. Thanks for the replies. Yes, I am doing great. Got remarried to a wonderful man who is a normal human being. Treats me good. Respects and supports my endeavors, as I do his. We are still in love after 28 years. Old people in love, eeeeyo. I didn't know what a good marriage or relationship was until I found one. Why did I wait so long? Don't know. My room amps wanted to rearrange the dorm room in college. We had bunk beds. I said we knew to break down the top bunk into pieces, take the mattress off, then the bottom spring bit, etc. She said no, we got this. We can just pick it up as a whole unit. I told her I do not possess enough strength to that. She told me it would be fine. So we lift this bed whole, straight off the bottom bed pegs. The height difference between us is over a foot. So I kinda dropped it trying to even it out with her end. And shock of all shocks, it ended up falling. She was backed against her windowsill. She tripped and fell back and her head caught the windowsill and the bed came down on her. One of the legs caught the sill and her head ended up being trapped between the bottom rung of the bed ladder and the sill. We had to yell and get some help. If that leg wouldn't have caught the windowsill, she would have had the whole weight of the bed come down on her exposed neck, breaking her neck, probably crushing her throat and who knows what else. Honestly, she was literal inches from death. We had to pause and just let that sink in for the rest of the night. The bed still got moved though. When my daughter was 7 weeks old, I was going out to the coffee shop around the block from my house. It was a rainy day, but had stopped briefly. I put her in my Mobi wrap and went out. I went and got coffee and a sandwich. On my way back home, I went to step up onto the sidewalk. Instead, my toe clipped the curb. I fell forward. My daughter was thrown out of the wrap and onto the sidewalk. Luckily, I was closer to the ground as I was falling as well, and the fall wasn't as far as it could have been. She began to cry immediately and all I could do was sit on the wet sidewalk, rocking back and forth crying, as a woman was standing next to me saying, "Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god." I didn't have my cell phone with me, BC, I was just running out. A kind gentleman let me use his and I called my husband who was working around the block. He was there in seconds. We went to the emergency room. Got lots of tests done. Watched as my 7-week-old daughter was placed in a CT scan. I felt so helpless. She was completely fine. It was the worst day of my life. I can still close my eyes and see her falling to the ground. Although this experience was terrifying, it taught me some important lessons. Kids are resilient. If they cry immediately, they're probably okay. If they move immediately, they're probably okay. You're gonna F things up as a parent, so be easy on yourself. 2 days ago, my boss sold the company I built completely on my own for the past 17 years. We had an agreement he would sell me the company when he was ready to retire. Instead, he packaged it up with his other company and sold it to another group. Never been so sick or pissed in my entire life. All my life goals are gone and everything has changed literally overnight, but I still have my IT job, so there's that, I guess. Literally a couple of days after my mum passed away, a guy decided to try and wind me up over it. He was yelling things like "Yo mama" jokes with the punchline being "she's dead." I snapped. Everything went red. I don't remember what led to it, but the next thing I remember is holding the guy at arm's length by the collar with him crying and crawling at my arm screaming something. Couldn't hear anything. What I realized next was I was holding him in the road. I looked to my right and saw a bus was coming, and the only thing I could think was that the bus was going to take my arms, plus the guy attached, and was strangely at peace with it. Luckily something switched back on in my head. The sound came back and all the peacefulness got turned into panic. Pulled the guy and myself away from the road. Stood over him for a bit. Wanted to ask if he was okay but just couldn't speak and just left the guy there on the pavement and walked home numb. Everything felt unreal. Once I got home and realized no one else was in the house, I went to the bathroom. Threw up. Wailed and cried until I was sore. Once I had calmed down and stopped being sick, I washed my arms from various cuts and scratches. Put on a long sleeve t-shirt and went to bed. For the next couple of weeks I barely spoke to anyone or ate while isolating myself to my room. Came across the guy a few times as the years went by. He always just walked away quickly and I always felt the strike of guilt. In high school I caught a special earful from one of my bullies and he embarrassed me in front of our entire class, and I swear I could have choked the life out of him and not changed a shade. But life is a funny thing and the way things work out are funny. We're now best friends, 12 years later, and we talk on the phone at least twice a week for an hour minimum. I just sent them for a meme for crying out loud. Funny how things work out. Pulling a knife on my dad after a heated argument. I was like 13, so it really couldn't have gone well on the fly, but I sure wanted it to.